Hi, how are you going? I hope you're feeling as well as possible on your medicines. I'm Pharmacist Fi. Welcome to my YouTube channel and to episode 8 of our series called What Went Wrong? Ms. J had asthma. She loved playing team sports, especially netball. But if she had training outdoors on cold mornings, breathing cold air occasionally triggered an asthma attack. And she was lucky that a few puffs of her asthma reliever called salbutamol was usually enough to settle her lungs down from these attacks quickly, which happened about once or twice a month. But in the small rural town she had recently moved to, since the spring grasses had started flowering by the roadside for a few weeks now, Ms. J had started getting asthma attacks multiple times a week. Plus, sometimes she even woke up at night coughing with that tight feeling in her lungs that made it much harder to breathe. So she went to see a local doctor who prescribed her a preventer medicine to try to prevent these asthma attacks from happening, which was a corticosteroid inhaler called fluticasone propionate. And the instructions on its label said, inhale one puff twice daily, because the doctor knew that this medicine only works well if you take it twice per day with about 12 hours between each dose. But different people interpret medicine instructions differently to each other. So because there was no info about whether any time was needed between the two puffs on the medicine label, Ms. J assumed that inhale one puff twice daily might mean the same thing as inhale two puffs daily. So she just inhaled two puffs each morning. And although the fluticasone propionate did reduce how many asthma attacks Ms. J got, it did not work as well as she and the doctor had expected it to, even after the full 8 weeks of consistent use, which it may take for a preventer to start having its maximum beneficial effect. Luckily for Ms. J, the doctor referred her for a home medicines review, and when the pharmacist asked her exactly how she was taking her fluticasone propionate, this was when the difference of the label interpretation was picked up. So now, Ms. J takes her preventer at 7 a.m. and 7 p.m. each day, and it is working well for her. However, please keep in mind that not every preventer medicine needs to be taken twice daily. For example, the much stronger preventer called fluticasone furoate should be taken only once a day. So, how could Ms. J have possibly avoided this medicine problem? Top tip number one. When a doctor or pharmacist advises you to take a certain amount of a medicine twice daily, for most medicines, they mean take that medicine once every 12 hours. Although there are some exceptions to this rule, where there may be a shorter time between doses, for example, 6 hours apart for some medicines. But still, when a doctor writes, take one twice daily on a medicine, they do not mean take two once a day. Top tip number two. If you ever have a medicine with instructions saying to take it twice daily, ask the doctor or pharmacist who gave you that medicine exactly how many hours apart the two doses should be. When they tell you, write that number of hours between doses straight onto your medicines, allergies, and contacts list in the section for that medicine, so you can check it regularly to remind you exactly how to take it. Top tip number three. Make a medicines, allergies, and contacts list with your doctor and pharmacist and take it to every doctor's appointment, including specialists, and every time you go to a pharmacy, so that you can get them to help you keep it updated. And then you can read your list regularly just before you take your medicines to try to always get the right dose of the right medicine taken the right way at the right time, every time, for each of your medicines. I will put links for you to videos about making a medicines, allergies, and contacts list into the description section below this video for you. Please click the subscribe and like buttons below this video if you'd like to see more of these medicine safety videos. And Denver and I look forward to catching up with you again very soon here on this Pharmacist Fi Medicine Safety YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. Bye.